tiny teach is about dichotomous keys for bacteria. The goal of a dichotomous key is to separate bacteria based on biochemical test results. So let's take a look at the biochemical test results for our six bacteria. The first thing you want to do is find a biochemical test result that divides your bacteria into about half. That's how you're going to start separating your bacteria. So if we take a look, the oxidase test doesn't help us. All the bacteria test negative. The glucose fermentation test doesn't help us. All the bacteria test positive. But lactose fermentation is just perfect. Half the bacteria test positive and half the bacteria test negative. So you would start your dichotomous key by putting gram-negative rods at the top. That's the bacteria we're separating, and then put lactose fermentation and positive and negative. Now what we need to do is start separating the bacteria. What I like to do is cover half of the bacteria that you're not separating just to make it easy. So I'm going to focus on just the three bacteria that are lactose fermentation positive and cover the three that are lactose fermentation negative. So what we need to do is find a test where these three lactose fermentation bacteria don't all test the same, because the goal is to start separating these three bacteria from each other based on biochemical testing. There's going to be a bunch of options here. Pick tests that you feel comfortable with. So a test that you feel comfortable performing and you feel comfortable interpreting. So we could do, for example, sucrose fermentation. We could do urease. We could do indole. We could do MR. We could do VP. We could even do citrate. Just pick a test that you feel comfortable with. I'm going to do indole. So in the next step, our dichotomous key would look like this. We would now have indole, positive and negative, and of the three bacteria, the only one that tested positive was E. coli. So now we need to go back to the biochemical testing chart, and we need to separate Enterobacter and Klebsiella. So now we just need to look at the biochemical testing results and find a test where they don't test the same. So if we take a look, for example, we could use urease because one test positive and one test negative. So that's the one that I'm going to use. So now our dichotomous key for that side would look like this. We added urease and we have positive, which is Klebsiella pneumoniae, and negative, which is Enterobacter aerogenes. And this whole side of our gram-negative rod dichotomous key is complete. We separated those three bacteria based on biochemical test results. Now we need to tackle this side of the dichotomous key, the lactose fermentation negative bacteria. So what I like to do again is I like to block the bacteria that I've already separated. So now I can just see the three bacteria I have left to separate and the biochemical test. So I just need to separate those three, and I just need to find a test where they don't all test the same. Again, there's going to be a couple different options. Just pick a test that you feel comfortable performing and interpreting the test result for. So as I look down here, I see that I could use urease. You can use urease on both sides of your key. That's perfectly appropriate. So we would go ahead and add urease to this side of the key, positive and negative. And of the three bacteria, the bacteria that was positive was Proteus mirabilis. We added that bacteria right here. Now we just need to go back to the biochemical testing chart again. We just need to separate Salmonella from Shigella. We need to look at our biochemical test results, and I can see, for example, down here, an option would be citrate. That is the test I'm going to use. So onto my dichotomous key, I added citrate Salmonella was positive, Shigella was negative, and my dichotomous key is complete. So that's how you do a dichotomous key for bacteria using biochemical test results.